Hey guys, welcome to Impel Racing. My name is Brian Cox, and today we're going to be installing a Bluetooth module onto a CC3D flight controller running Betaflight or CleanFlight. In this case, installing it onto an Eachine Falcon 250. And this way you can program the PIDs or any of the settings right on the field using your cell phone or simply connecting to the CleanFlight configurator. Okay, so the first step you actually want to do is to take apart your quadcopter. Before you do that, make sure if you're doing any work inside of CleanFlight or configuring it at all, always take your props off. So let's do that right now. Okay, so once you get the props off, you can go ahead and start taking the top plate off. There'll be 8 total screws that you actually need to take out. So let's go ahead and pull the top plate off. Okay, let's go ahead and set our copter to the side here. So once we have that all taken apart, we actually need to program our Bluetooth device here. And to do that, we're gonna have to make sure we connect the correct pins to it. So it's pretty simple. It's already marked. You're gonna see the correct markings on the back here. You just connect it with the corresponding ones. Now, the one thing you do have to do is you have to switch the RX and the TX. Otherwise, it won't talk. But it's a pretty simple setup here. So you'll see an on-screen graphic for that. The actual connection diagram, but I'm going to connect these guys up really quick. And then from here, we can plug it into our computer. Okay, so once you have the Bluetooth device actually plugged into your computer, it should have a red light blinking on it. If it's not having any lights on it at all, double check your connections, make sure they're plugged in correctly. So the first thing you want to do is actually download the actual piece of software you're going to be programming the Bluetooth device with. In this case, I did Arduino. So just go ahead and go to, the link will be in the description, but it's arduino.cc, and just go to the download and download for your correct OS. From there, actually launch Arduino, and you want to find out what serial port your Bluetooth device is actually connected to, and you can figure that out pretty easily by going to Device Manager, and then locating this thing right here where it says Silicon Labs. USB to UART bridge, COM3. So I know it's COM3 when I'm trying to connect, because you're gonna need to know what COM it is when you're actually trying to connect into the Arduino program here. And let me show you guys how to set the COM. And it's actually port right here. So right now I'm on COM3 because that was the correct COM in the device manager. So make sure that's go ahead and selected. Go to the serial monitor and make sure everything's actually talking. But before you do that, you're gonna need to check the baud rate. Right now, mine is at 115/200. I already set mine previously to that, so whatever your baud rate is, it should be listed on the manufacturer's webpage. Banggood.com, I believe, listed their baud rate. I'm gonna show you how to change the baud rate in just a second here. So once you have the correct baud rate selected, go ahead and type AT, and you should get a command back where it says okay. That means your board is actually talking correctly, and from there, we can actually do the programming pieces. Okay, so let's go ahead and actually set the baud rate to the rate I found used in CleanFlight and Betaflight, which is actually the baud rate I'm on right now, which is the 115/200. And to get to that rate, you go AT plus baud 8. So that'll go ahead and set it to the 115/200. Now, if you had a different rate beforehand, you're gonna go ahead and need to change it down at the bottom down here to match the new rate and then connect to it again and just verify you are connecting again by just typing AT simply. You're gonna get an okay. So now let's set the actual name of the device wherever you want it to be. AT plus name, Impel Racing 250. Okay, name is set. And now if you guys want to set a pin, the default pin should be 1234. I'm going to go ahead and set mine to that. You can set it to whatever you want. This is the pin you actually type in when connecting to your Bluetooth device. So AT plus pin 1234. Okay, pin set. And that's all you have to do from here. So let's go ahead and disconnect and then start hooking it into the actual board. Okay, so once you have the board actually programmed, the next thing we're gonna have to do is actually connect the wire that is going to talk to your board. Mine didn't come with one. Obviously, if you bought the Eachine Falcon 250, you're not gonna have an extra wire in the kit. So this is the actual one I got from sparkfun.com was the cheapest place that I could find this actual wire from. And it's actually a JST-SH, and it's a 4-pin. I'll have the links below, but you can kind of see here what this wire is going to be. So your actual pinout for this is going to be your ground, your 5 volts, your TX, and then your RX right here. So make sure you get that correct, especially your ground and your voltage right here, because that could cause some problems. So now we're actually going to connect our Bluetooth device into our actual correct pinouts here. So first we have is our voltage. That would be our second pin from coming from the CC3D board. Next would be ground, your black here. Next would be your RX going into your TX. And then last, we have the TX going into RX. Make sure these are swapped because it actually won't talk to anything, because these TX and RX pins need to be swapped going into the board. And that's all there is from there. So let's go ahead and connect that up to our actual CC3D board. Now it's gonna go into this main port right here. You can only plug this in one way, but make sure you get it in correct anyways. Make sure it's nice and snug, just like that. So, and from there, we're actually gonna need to go into the CleanFlight configurator and change some settings, because default, the incorrect port is open. So let's do that right now. Okay, so before you actually connect a battery to your device here, always make sure your transmitter is on. The other thing you wanna make sure of is make sure your video transmitter antenna is on, because if it's not and you power it up with it, without it on, it will fry your transmitter. So always make sure this is connected whenever you have power running through this thing. Okay, so let's go ahead and make sure nothing's touching here. Go ahead and grab transmitter. All right, let's go ahead and power up. And this is why we are doing a Bluetooth setup, is because this is a total pain in the butt. Okay, now we're connected there. Let's go ahead and connect to via USB. Okay, so the first thing you wanna actually do is go under the port setting here. By default on my Eachine Falcon 250, UART3 was turned on. That is not the correct port. The main port is actually UART1. Now this may be switched on some other the models out there, because I read some other guides out there and it said UART3 was the main port, but in fact I found UART1 was the main port. So go ahead and make sure that is on as indicated right here. And then you should be able to get a connection to it. And that's really the last step you need to do. Right now I'm connected via USB. So let's go ahead and disconnect and then verify that our Bluetooth connection is actually working. Okay, so once you have your device connected, plugged in, powered up, all that stuff, what you need to do is actually pair your device. So go ahead and click on, under Bluetooth settings, pair. Type in your super secret passcode coming up here in just a second. Gonna install for a second here. We are connected. So to figure out what port you need to go to Device Manager yet again. And it more than likely gonna have two ports, one's an ingoing and one's an outgoing port. I typically find that the higher number port is the correct port to connect to. So make sure your baud rate is at the 115/200. Select COM, in my case 17, it could be whatever for yours. Again, it's the higher one. Try them both if one doesn't work for some reason, and then go ahead and connect. Give it a second, it's a little slower than USB. And there we have it. We are connected to CleanFlight Configurator via Bluetooth. This is great, especially for models that have really inconvenient USB ports to get to. Or really the best part is tuning out on the field with a cell phone, and I'll show you that in just a second here. Okay, so what you can actually do once you have got your Bluetooth set up is you can actually download this great app called Easy GUI. Go ahead and click on that guy there. And you're gonna need to actually set up a couple of settings inside there. You actually need to probably connect your Bluetooth device beforehand on here. So go under settings, make sure it's set on Bluetooth. Go ahead and select by device or Bluetooth device. You can see mine, I just named here Impel Racing 250. Go ahead and hit next, whatever your device is. Make sure you're on CleanFlight if you're running CleanFlight. This is also the same setting you wanna have for Betaflight, which I'm running Betaflight 2.6.1. Go ahead and hit next. I just left all this stuff at default here. again, I don't have any of these things here. So default, and again, default. So once that's all set up, you should be able to hit connect on your button right here.
Connecting.
It's gonna ask to pair the device. Again, my super secret password.
Connected.
So from here, you can see all your stuff. You can see your PIDs, which is absolutely fantastic to have this out on the field to be able to adjust right here. And you can actually read and record all your PIDs right here, your expo settings, all that stuff. There are some other things too. You can actually get to, your CLI and a bunch of other features too. So it's really, really great to have, especially if you're a new pilot and you're not used to tuning your PIDs. And it's just a really quick way, especially with this model here, the USB port is just really unfortunately inconvenient to get to. So, all right guys, that's it for the tutorial. If you have any questions, be sure to comment below. Otherwise, happy flying.